A few months ago, back in December, Golf Le Fleur opened up a 12-day pop-up shop in Culver City, California, transforming an empty parking lot into a unique Le Fleur experience. After going to the store and browsing through the selection, I found a couple pieces that caught my eye. And today, I'm gonna share what I got from the Le Fleur pop-up shop.
Hey, today I'm gonna be showcasing a few items that I bought at the Golf Le Fleur pop-up shop. Keep in mind that I did purchase these items about a month ago. So even though I wore a couple of the items, I put them back in the box. First things first, I bought the Golf Le Fleur trucker hat. Hat's pretty plain, it just says Le Fleur right in the front logo. Other than that, it says Golf Le Fleur on the inside tag as well. And that's pretty much it as far as branding goes. I find that the inner lining, being a microfiber cloth type material, helps keep it on your head better. Because I could put it on my head at like all different angles, like see this. I don't know, I feel like it just allows you to put it on your head and it just kind of stays there. This hat is made by Otto. I haven't really heard of Otto. When I looked up Otto, I saw they had blanks on Amazon for like 10 bucks. I don't know if this is the same hat as that. Just with the screen print, but it's a nice hat either way. Moving on to, we have the
Le Fleur flower petal t-shirt.
The shirt's pretty awesome, I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty awesome. I went ahead and got it in a medium, which I feel like is a good size for my stature. Nothing on the back, but on the front we have a beautiful textured screen printed logo. We have the Le Fleur tag on the inside, which features the dog. Not much to say about the shirt, really. I really love the logo on it. There's a few other colors, I think like an orange or pink. I like it a lot. 100% cotton, made in America. By the way, all the items came with the usual digicamo wrapping paper. Really nice wrapping paper. It always has a nice smell to it, too. Just smells like a... smells kind of sweet. Next item on the list, digicamo mohair sweater vest. In a beautiful blue and green colorway. Just take it all in. Here's the front side. On the back, small flower patch on the bottom left corner here. If you look within the pattern, you can see that it says Fleur right across the bottom mid torso there. And we have another dog tag label on the neck area. But this time around it's pink. On the t-shirt, that tag was blue. The colors here, we have two different shades of blue, a nice Grinch green, and then a pop of yellow inside. I've worn it maybe a couple times already. It is a little itchy, I'm not gonna lie. I always wear it with a t-shirt. I don't know why you would wear a vest without a shirt underneath. But if you try to wear this vest without a shirt, you're gonna be scratched up. Itchiness aside, this is a great vest. This sweater is actually made of three different materials. 67% mohair, 28% nylon, and 5% wool. For reference, this vest is the same style print. However, this vest, which came out last year, I believe, is 100% mohair. They look about the same side by side. So I just thought it was interesting that this older piece is 100% mohair. And the newer pieces they have are a mixture of wool, nylon, and mohair. I'm out of breath. Moving on, we have this. Some of you may recognize this sweater from Tyler, the Creator's set during Camp Flogno last year.
Damn, I gotta fuck my legs.
Now, sometimes people can't tell what this is. I mean, I think it's kind of obvious. It's a pair of legs wearing some socks and loafers. And it says Le Fleur in cursive at the bottom. On the inside tag, it has the old flower patch tag rather than the new updated dog tag version tag. And if you're wondering, this piece is 100% virgin wool made in Italia. Moving on to the last piece here. It's actually something that I wanted to buy in the pop-up shop. However, they were sold out. But I was able to get it online.
Nice.
So for the last item, we have the actually don't know what this is called.
The Daryl Hoodie by Golf Le Fleur.
Yeah, they had these available in the pop-up, but the size that I wanted was sold out. Out of all the pieces that I bought, this is definitely my most worn. Probably just because it's a hoodie. On the inside, we do have that new dog logo tag and a nice clean graphic here on the front. Another nice touch on this hoodie is a small leather flower patch on the bottom left cuff here. The same patch can be found on the sweater vest as well. Also, all of the items that I got came with this little tag. There's no price on it or item description, but all of the items had this on there. Okay, so these are all of the items I bought at the Golf Le Fleur pop-up, except for this. I already had this. In case I forgot, I got this in a medium, this in a medium, this in a medium. This one's medium too, but this sweater vest is small. And the hat, snap back. So now we're gonna put on some clothes and show you how everything fits on my body.
Y'all get some more drinks going on. I sound a whole lot better.